Everybody, it's Genghis Khan and happy Mardi Gras, baby. It is Mardi Gras 2014, and we are jumping into a whole bunch of New Orleans inspired video games. I love this holiday. I love that fucking city. New Orleans is one of the coolest cities in the fucking country, and I feel like it doesn't get nearly the appreciation it deserves. Because just on music alone, god damn. Speaking of which, we came in on Professor Longhorn because we gotta pay motherfucking respect. That Professor Longhorn come to the Mardi Gras. Probably fucked that up. And we are going to be doing, underneath this right now, you're actually hearing a music bed. I don't know what yet. Like always, all the music selection information will be in the show notes. Or I guess that would be the description on the video. And we are jumping into a new one this time. But I am in love with New Orleans. I love that motherfucking city. And I just kind of wanted to pay some respect and do some fun games to get everybody in the mood for Mardi Gras. Because it's fucking carnival. And it's time for everybody to get out and go drink something proper. Have some fun. Make some new friends and eat some amazing food, because if you're not eating food, what are you doing, bro? You're fucking up. So, without further motherfucking ado, we are jumping into our first game of the day, which is going to be a really weird one that I found. It's fucking weird. And it's actually called it's an old NES game that I knew about because of Wikipedia, thank God. I was trying to figure out New Orleans games, didn't know which one to jump into, and one of the ones I saw was this old NES game. This one took a little bit of finding, actually, because there's, like, I was originally going to do Death Race, which has a New Orleans level, but every level looks the same in that game, so it's kind of like a push. I was like, eh, what's the fucking point? And then I saw this game, The Adventures of Bayou Billy, which I was not familiar with, but it's really crazy. It's basically like if you were to take a bayou or like basically fucking hillbilly Louisiana version of what's the fucking Aussie dude that wasn't really Australian? The That's Not a Knife, that guy. It's basically the bayou version of that dude, from what I can tell. So we're just gonna jump into this. I'm gonna power this shit on and hopefully we will get this going. Let me see if this is gonna work. Powered on, boom, and we're recording. There we go. I'm playing this on controller, of course, because what the fuck, why would I not be? Apologies, let me get my volume set and everything. Cool, and we are good. Let's do this shit. All right, we should be good now. Sorry, that took a second. I had to mess with a bunch of settings because of my recorder, and this should work now. So we can jump right in. It's up to you to rescue Annabelle. Oh, also I have a beer. I'm gonna crack that open. Do I have the courage? You know it. I am drinking a Blackened Voodoo. Do I have the courage to fight Gordon? Okay, I'm tired of this. That was ridiculous. I am drinking a Blackened Voodoo, which is from Dixie. And if you know anything about Dixie Brewing Company, they were originally out of New Orleans. And they actually, because of the storm, got transplanted. And now they're brewing out of a contract brewery. There you go. So, this is a very early NES game, if you can't tell. But they Dixie Brewing actually got... is now contract brewing out of, I believe, Wisconsin. So, out of respect, I figure I would drink the beer that is currently outside in New Orleans, even though it wants to be there, because I'm in the same goddamn boat. Not only that, but technically, I believe they actually just ruled and they actually just decided that they are going to get rid of that brewery, which is sad, that building. I guess it took 10 feet of water damage during the storm. Katrina, obviously, which is super sad. This is crazy. Okay, so this dude just captured... Okay, so we're going straight to stage 6. Here, I'll pause right when we get here. Here we go. Okay, so here we are. We went straight to stage 6 because I, like a professional, used a Game Genie code and got us right to the New Orleans level. So here we are on Bourbon Street, and here's... I know it's basically a side-scrolling beat-em-up... Oh my god. Side-scroller beat-em-up, but... Haven't really played much of it. I played like 2 seconds to make sure it worked, and it works all right. Also, full disclosure, pretty sure I'm using an infinite lives code right now. Also on the Game Genie, just because, wow, why not? Because this game, I played like 2 seconds of it and realized it's crazy hard. So it'd be more fun if I don't die constantly. So we'll just do all that, and we'll see if that shit's even working. I'm not positive it is. And I'm going to drink on this Dixie beer straight up. Well, not out of New Orleans, but... By way of Wisconsin out of New Orleans. And I've got all kinds of... I'm actually... Unfortunately... Or fortunately... It's a great strain, but I have Blackwater Kush that I'm smoking. Seems a little on the nose, and it's kind of weird. So it's all in theme today. And I just wanted to give love back to the Crescent City. Because god damn, do they make amazing music and food and... Really, everything. God damn, what isn't cool about New Orleans? So let's get into this shit. I'm gonna beat everybody up in the face because I think I'm invincible. So let's do this shit. He's not even coming at me, bro. Alright, so we got that button and that button. Right, because we're on NES. This is on NES, by the way. I'm obviously emulating it. I'm not even gonna lie. Yep, I'm invincible. I just figured out because he tried to hit me and nothing happened. Oh, wait, no, I'm not. That's not good. I'm not invincible. Wait, maybe I am. I wonder if I... Well, we'll find out if I ever run out of lives. Or I should say when I run out of lives. I found out really the way to play this game is you run in and you kick somebody and you run out. But really today, I just wanted to make some videos and pay respect to all the fucking awesome musicians and everybody in New Orleans. Also, the show Treme is fucking amazing. And I just thought it was cool that a bunch of dudes I knew, both my Connect and... Dune of Dune Reads Goosebumps were recently in New Orleans like a couple weeks ago for some of the parades and everything, and they got to see some of the second lines. I think they saw, I forget which, I think Dune went to the Star Wars parade, which is fucking exactly where he should have been. So it's awesome, and I just love that city, man. No, it's amazing that that city still fucking exists, and its history is so fucking interesting. With it just being a, it's bait, I mean, talk about a goddamn diverse place. Like, there's a billion different cultures in that motherfucker. And everybody, oh shit, I just died. Oh yeah. I think that R is our health. So I think we might be invincible, but we can still die is the thing. Like, we just don't have game overs, I think, is how this works. I'm guessing. But, this is awesome, though. I'm actually kind of liking this game. It's a fun little beat-em-up, and it's totally New Orleans-themed. But we have a couple games we're going to be covering today. Trust me, this isn't going to be the only one, because that would be a disservice. There's also some that we aren't going to get to today, just out of fear, or out of sheer time of me having to play through that much of them to get to them. I'm playing this the wrong way. I'm playing this like a fucking Double Dragons. I need to be playing this all stealthy, but we do have a bunch of them coming up, so... Oh god, that's terrifying. I've never played this game back on NES. Definitely had an NES, definitely never played this game on it. I think that's how you do it, is you stand up here, you wait for him to throw, and then when he throws, you like... Yeah, like that. Like, get him to throw, and then you fucking hit him like that. Ah, bitch! Boom. Yeah, dummy. Man, we're doing good. This game is fun. It's weird, but it's fun. Oh god, this one's gonna be hard. Oh god. I originally started finding out, I mean, I knew a lot about New Orleans because of, I mean, just a lot of stuff. When you're in school and stuff, you learn a lot about some of that stuff. Like, and I read the book, The Awakenings. Shout out to whatever chick fucking author that was, and whatever crazy, angry, militant chick English teacher I had back in the day. But I read that book when I was in, what was that, middle school? High school? I guess it was high school. And crazy book. But that was actually, that teacher was awesome. That teacher got me to read a lot. I think I read Gatsby because of that teacher too. But between that and between the, well, really a lot of it was Dr. John. Loved Dr. John because of, I would see him on old SNL and shit, and he was awesome. And then I found out Dr. John was from New Orleans, and I was like, oh shit, that makes a lot of sense, because that dude is super cool, but he definitely has like this weird, like fucking just sauce to him. He's just a fucking, that dude has got way more flavor than everybody else. I was like, what the hell? So eventually I figured out he was from New Orleans, and then I started watching the show Treme, and after seeing like the Spike Jonze documentaries and stuff, because I heard they were using some of the people from that, and god damn is the show Treme amazing. Like, I've heard from my buddy, actually my connect, when he was down there, he said a lot of people that are down there actually really like that show, and I can't imagine they wouldn't, because it's the closest you can get to I mean, it's all real characters, basically. They're like, almost everybody's based on real people, and they have actually a lot of real people playing themselves. Like Kermit Ruffins, the trumpet player, plays himself, and is fucking awesome in it. He's hilarious. There's a bunch of people though. Like, there's a chick who plays this trumpet player's wife, who was in the Spike Jonze documentary, and she's fucking fantastic. Like, actually, some of the real people are some of the best actors in that show. It's pretty interesting. It also doesn't help that it's made, or it also doesn't hurt, rather, that it's made by the same guy, David Simon, who made The Wire. He's like the creative director or whatever for The Wire back in the day. So that guy is fucking fantastic. And that show, it definitely tells. I mean, it definitely shows. Cause it's just so fuck. I really like this game, actually. This is a fun little old school NES beat 'em up that I don't think anybody played. There are, full disclosure, there are levels in this game that straight up suck. Like, there's a lot of them. There's a lot of really bad levels. There's a lot of driving levels where you have to shoot guns that are really tough. This is like one of the easiest levels that I've played so far. Actually, I only played a couple of them. Try to feel this out a little bit. Shit. Yeah, got you, dummy. The key with most of these things is just to try to hit them at an angle and then keep moving. Because if once you hit them once, you're cool. But it's if you get stuck standing in front of them, it's when you get screwed. Oh god. Oh god. Fuck you, dude. Fuck you. Fuck you, Sonny. Oh god. But I like that it straight up says bourbon, like, so it's Bourbon Street right there and everything. It's fun. I just thought, this game's fun that it themed a level so hard on this game. Or, I mean, on the city. And there's one glaring omission to mine, and I know about it. And we're not doing it because I didn't want to play through fucking 7 hours of shooting zombies in the face to really lose pretty hard and repetitively, because I'm not, haven't been played through that game that much. Oh man, we were beating on him too. Damn it, I need to stop leaning into him like that. I'm drinking the Blackened Voodoo, which is the black lager from Dixie though, and it's really tasty. It'd be bomb with some barbecue. Reminds me, it's a lot like, I'm trying to think of one that it reminds me of. It's pretty light. But it also is pretty sweet. And like, actually reminds me of does Gordon Biersch make a chocolate bock or something like that? If they do, it reminds me of that. I feel like Gordon Biersch might. Or somebody like that. Not Sam Adams. Somebody else has one that's, cause Sam Adams' chocolate bock is a lot different than this. This is a lot lighter. It reminds me of, I don't know what black lager, some black lager, maybe the Guinness black lager a little bit. Well, we got back here real quick. Oh, this is what they mean by... Wait, no, I don't know if this is what they mean by... Oh, God. It's doing good, though, so far. Oh, God. See, the key is you just can't stay there for that long. Oh, shit. And you gotta keep these dudes separate, or else they're fucking dangerous. So I've been watching the show Treme again, because I love that fucking show. It's one of my favorite. And John Goodman is amazing in it. Steve Zahn is amazing in everything, always, of all time. Steve Zahn's amazing. When is Steve Zahn not amazing? Hey, I like that dude since That Thing You Do. Oh, what? Right when we got past that, too. This game is super fun. I would have expected to be angry. Oh, look, there's checkpoints. Nice. Don't have my whip anymore, though. Alright, here we go. Come on, bro. Alright, fine. I'm not gonna fuck with you like that. I'll just go like this. Dummy. What's good, dummy? Sidekick. Sidekick. Liver shot. Liver shot. Liver shot. Liver shot. Yeah, get that knife, bro. Oh, no. I didn't know it was a throw. Fuck you, bro. Get knifed. Oh, man. Alright. Oh, man. So, if you guys don't know, if you're looking for things to do on Mardi Gras, first off, if you don't have WWOZ on, I mean, I kind of don't want to know you. WWOZ every year is all I listen to most of Mardi Gras, except for like some Big Frida, or if I want to listen to like specific stuff. But they have a they generally cover a lot of cool stuff. They actually do some bounce. They actually cover some like legit stuff here and there throughout the day. A lot of it's just traditional stuff though, which I love. I think it's great. Somebody needs to be playing it, and they're the ones that should be doing it. And they have a they actually have an app for both Android and iPhone. If you need a if you're trying to play any kind of Mardi Gras or New Orleans theme music on Mardi Gras, you can go check out their app on the App Store for both Android and Apple. I'm pimping this shit because I've been using it forever because it's amazing. Such a big fan of WWOZ, actually. I really like those guys. I think they're fucking cool. They play some awesome stuff. Plus, it's just, everything sounds so different than what it does out here. Everything sounds so fucking bland in San Diego. Like, we don't have any, we have almost no horn players in the city, you know what I mean? And none of them do any kind of anything that's fun. This dude is dressed so fucking Crocodile Dundee, it's ridiculous. Finally remember the name of that movie. Those sidekicks are legit, though. I'm just fucking this dude up with sidekicks. Boom. What's good, son? Brow. Pow. Brow. Brow. Pow. That's... So we are infinite lives, but just infinite lives, not infinite health. I'm understanding now. I think there is an infinite energy one that I could have done. I just didn't do that, which is kind of more fun, because then we at least get to advance with, like, checkpoints, which I'm cool with. Zero problems with checkpoints, dude. Because I would not play this game all the way through anyway. I just like the, wow, it's getting chunky, isn't it? Full disclosure, I think I did say I'm playing on the emulator, so if it gets chunky like that, good chance the emulator. It might have been the game back in the day, though. I don't know. I don't think there's a lot of footage of this game. There's some, but not... Oh, no, Death Race has zero footage, because every level looks the same, so nobody even played that shit. But, man, this game is fucking... I like this shit. This is the funnest side-scrolling beat-em-up New Orleans-themed game I've played so far. Go figure. This shit is super fun, actually. I'm surprised. Oh, God damn it. I think we got a checkpoint, though. Yeah, we did. So I don't know what everybody's out there doing on Mardi Gras. I would suggest go make a gumbo and... Well, worst case, just watch some Treme. Or just put on a Dr. John album, really. Any of that shit'll work. play yourself some Professor Longhair like a fucking gangster. Professor Longhair, go watch a video of Professor Longhair. That dude is amazing and hilarious, and he's the ODB of Louisiana, as far as I'm concerned. That dude looks so legit about his shit. It's hilarious. Oh, wow. I got fucking straight up wailed on. Fuck you, bro. Oh, man. You're brutal. Fuck you. Take that caning, bro. God. Man, New Orleans has so much cool history. I don't know if you guys know much about the history of New Orleans, but it's really interesting since they're settled by the French mostly. There's a long, long, weird history because the French weren't as dickish to slaves as all the white people were, especially like the German and the Dutch. So there was a lot of, like, they had Sundays off, which is why the Congo Square was such a poppin' ass place on Sundays. Everybody would go and fucking dance and play music and shit on Sundays at the square, which is like, that's why all the second lines and all that shit goes on now, from what I can tell, or at least from what I've heard. So fucking cool, man. I like, if you talk about San Diego history, it's like, oh yeah, it's like these white people were here and they were like, you know, they were like, hey Mexicans, you guys need to walk south a little bit, and then they were like, hey, you can't smoke on this beach, and this is our shit, so we're gonna stab anybody who is, and then everybody of this certain color go downtown in this one area, and then it's so like weird. I don't know, San Diego's so gentrified, like everybody's in their, like, it's so separated. It's a lot like, it's not as bad as LA, but everywhere in San Diego is very different from everywhere else. Like East County is so fucking different from fucking up north, which is so different from downtown, which is so different from fucking Claremont, which is different from PB, which is, it's just all weird. And also, it's not a, well, I guess, I don't know, I just wish, like, San Diego doesn't have a great history of musicianship like that city does, man. God damn it, New Orleans has, like, the coolest history of musicianship. And that they just encourage musicians so much. Like, everywhere has, like, I'm pretty sure, I can only imagine you can be playing outside on a corner in San Diego for maybe a couple minutes at a time before the cops kick you out. Like, I cannot imagine that shit going down for more than a couple minutes. This dude's just whooping my ass. Yeah. Fuck you, bro. Boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, but if you haven't seen the show Treme, go watch that shit. It's cool, and you actually get a good sense of history, a pretty decent sense of history for that city. They do a lot to try to teach you. Because David Simon, I mean, when you think about The Wire, like, The Wire taught you so much about Baltimore and about just people in the area, how the politicians were working, and this is like that, but on like, without all the drug dealing distraction behind it. Like, there's still some of that element, obviously, because it's a David Simon show, but like, it's more of a result of the city and of the things going on in the city than it is affecting the city. Like, the city is getting affected by it, but I don't know, it's weird. It's very interesting how New Orleans really feel like, it felt like in, I guess the best way to explain it is in The Wire, it felt like the main character was like the game, like the drug dealing game, like that was the main character, like selling and the dealers in that and the police against it was the, that was the that was the character in that show, was just drugs in general and laws against them. In New Orleans, I mean, in Treme, the entire show is, as far as I can tell, feels like it's just basically about... God damn it. I'm wailing on it, but this is getting rough. But the entire show, the main character in that show always feels like the city. It feels like everybody's just acting with the city. It's really cool. And especially with the inclusion of all the actual people. Like, all the real people, like, you can tell, but it's not in a, it's kind of cool every time, because you can tell, like, the Indian chiefs are all the real Indian chiefs and shit, because they're, like, not awkward on film, but they just, they look and act like real people that would be in a, that are trying to act, like, but it's not, it's really enjoyable, actually. I've never seen it in that, I don't know, it's weird, because you know these are the people that are kind of getting to experience, like, and live out in a kind of a more positive way a horrible situation that they all went through. And it's cool to see, like, the actual people not having to stand by and watch somebody else do them for them, but they get to just, like, be there and be part of it. It's fucking interesting, man. And they're, like, they consult with, David Simon, of course, is notorious for consulting with a ton of people in the city that are just part of the city. Like, the more notable ones I can think of is the main chef chick, Jeanette, or whatever, in that show. She is based on, I forget the girl's name, but she has two, you can look it up if you just search main chef or whatever from, or what's that, she's blonde, I think her name's Jeanette, but in that, she actually has a couple restaurants in New Orleans, the chick she's based on, and she was actually friends with the radio DJ guy, McLeary, who was based on a real guy, who was a radio DJ at WWOZ, and used to play bounce and get yelled at for it and shit. And not only that, the Chiefs are all based on real people, everybody's based on real people, from what I can tell. I'm not everybody, but like a lot of the main characters, and the guy who plays Antoine Batiste is based on a real musician who was a trumpet player, still is, and his wife, the chick who plays that character's wife in the show, is one of the people who was an actual resident and was in the Spike Jonze documentary and shit. It's just so cool, like, what he did with that show is so fucking fascinating, and it's something that could, it's amazing that it ever got done. Like, I'm amazed that shit ever got made. And not only did it get made, it got four fucking seasons, and they're all fantastic. Like, they're absolutely fantastic. And the music and everything, and they got Kermit Ruffins is fucking playing himself, and he's amazing in it. Like, I love everything about that show. I actually showed my buddy that show, who, I can't even get him to watch The Fucking Wire, but he was like, because he likes, because he's somewhat of a guitarist and shit, he was super stoked on it. Like, it's just so good. Oh god, is that show. I'm just blathering about how great that show is and how much I love New Orleans, but it's all fucking fact, because that shit is fantastic. And just know that all day, I'm just going to be listening to WWOZ, drinking a bunch of these Dixie Black and Voodoos, and then going to the bar and getting drunk with everybody like I'm supposed to be. But it's going to be such a blast. I'm so excited. This is getting hard. I'm not really trying to finish this level. We might, but not really my plan. My plan is kind of just to, like, dick around in this, and then we're going to jump into the next one, which is going to be more fun. From here, they get way more fun, because they're way more recent, and they are ones that I've actually played before, one of, at least. The other one, I'm not sure that I've played, which is going to make it really interesting. I think that one's up next. Actually, maybe not. Maybe it's the one after that that's up next. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Oh, yeah. No, that's right. That's not what's up next. I remember now. Sorry. I was trying to think that through in my head. Oh god, he's starting to wail on me. Get the whip so that way you can stay back. Yeah. No. Yeah. God, I love the fucking show, Trey Matt. Just seeing the backgrounds and stuff is reminding me of that goddamn... Oh man, why did I grab that? That was dumb. Just seeing the backgrounds and stuff of this is reminding me of that show. Just because they shoot everything in the city, all the bars are based on the bars in the city, and they take place in the bars in the city. Even the bars that are supposed to be out of town are bars that are in New Orleans. Like, it's so fucking cool what David Simon did with all that. Oh shit. We beat it. How was Bourbon Street? Did you like the present I sent ya? Well, that is where we're gonna wrap this, but... Oh, look, this is so pretty. Oh yeah, this is actually a shooting game also. Like, I forgot about that. See? It's like a shooting game also. It's weird. It combines both, and not that effectively from what I can tell. This is actually kind of Bourbon Street theme too. But that was... This has been... Oh god. Let's just do a little bit of this. Let's just... Oh god, I can't do... I need to just... Can we just... There we go. Much better. And boom. There we go. Much better. So that was The Adventures of Bayou Billy, an old NES game by Konami. It has a awesome New Orleans level. That was level 7, if you're curious, that we played through. And it is really weird, but a lot of fun. And I kind of like that level. I didn't really play much of the rest of the game. The stuff I did play was kind of rough. But that one level in particular, kind of fucking fantastic. So up next, we are jumping into the very first game I thought of when I thought of New Orleans games, which was, of course, there's one game, right? Everybody's like, oh, you know what was a really good New Orleans level? Of course it is Tony Hawk Pro Skater. Actually, it was Tony Hawk Underground 2, I should say. Oh, look, they're actually playing on the same level. That's amazing. So, I wonder if the demo automatically went to that because the Game Genie code. That's hilarious if it did. But, so we are going to play Tony Hawk Underground 2, of course, on the New Orleans level because it is so fucking fun. So that is what we have next. And then we actually have two more videos after that, if everything goes according to plan. And, I can get it. What, there's a jump button? Did not find that. Wonder what that was. That would have been useful. Anyway, so we have that coming up. So look for our next video. It's going to be coming. And until next time, we are going to go listen to some fucking amazing music. I suggest you do too. Get your red beans and rice out. Go get a king cake and share it with some people. God damn it, everybody. Happy Mardi Gras, baby. Everybody go do something proper. Go drink something and eat something decadent, as I always try to say. And until next time, we will be back with all kinds of craziness. So, till next time, motherfuckers, go do something decadent and happy Mardi Gras.